Hey my loves, welcome back to another one brand tutorial. I created this look using products by Sugar Cosmetics. Over the years, I have tried a lot of Sugar lipsticks, but past 6 months, I have tried a lot of Sugar Cosmetics makeup. I did try almost everything, leaving an eyeshadow palette because I felt that I already have those shades and I really don't want to put in my money on a palette where I'm getting the same similar shades which I already have in many other palettes of mine. So leaving that eyeshadow palette part, I did grab almost everything what they have launched so far. And yes, I have done dedicated review videos already on these products which I'm going to show you today. But yes, during this one brand tutorial, you will actually know, have any thoughts of mine changed on certain products, and even the application part may differ or may change, because yes, as and when you start using a product, experiencing the product more, you realize that this is the right technique to use a product. And with Sugar Cosmetics, I have realized that my technique has changed a lot. So here I am with this brand tutorial. I will be leaving down everything in my description if you want to grab anything for yourself. And before you jump on to the application part, consider subscribing and following me on my Instagram @pranzigi. So let's get started. First up, I'm going to prep my skin using the Base of Glory Pore Minimizing Primer by Sugar Cosmetics. Again, one of my favorite primers to use. It's the primer which I can use blindly with any kind of foundation I'm wearing. Because since it's being a silicone based primer, it's super light and it doesn't flake in during the day. Even if you're wearing a super matte foundation, this primer holds it up really well and give you nice luminosity even if you're wearing a full matte foundation. So yes, the primer is really good for all skin types. Moving on to some foundations. So yes, I do have two foundations by Sugar. One of them is the Ace of Face foundation. It's a stick based foundation, buttery, smooth, very lightweight, comfortably sit on the face, and it will not make your face look drier or patchy, because most of the stick foundations can go wrong, but in drugstore category, this is one of the best you can go for. They have good shades, but I still miss some deeper shades, but this is the perfect match to my skin, 47 Borgia. Wonderful foundation, really well made. Don't expect too much out of this foundation. It's not that medium to full coverage foundation, but it's the foundation which any girl can just easily wear it on everyday basis, office going, college going. This will be your best friend. To give a little more luminosity and a little more base or little more coverage, I went ahead with the Drop the Base serum foundation. I've done a full review on this foundation if you want to know more on this, but this is the foundation which I personally didn't like it as a foundation by itself, but a product which I love mixing with many other foundations of mine which are wholly solely matte foundations. This product in particular make any foundation of mine more comfortable, more skin-like, and it gives a nice glow to my base. This is the foundation which comes into picture where I want to wear a very heavy foundation but still doesn't want to look cakey or too heavy. This is the foundation you can mix in with other foundation of yours. Moving on to some color correction. So yes, I didn't know where to put this orange corrector, because whenever I put this orange corrector by Sugar, I feel it do cancel my facial hairs around my mouth area, but I still feel that it's a way deeper shade for my skin. So first I just placed the product and then straight up went to my contour stick, again the face forward stick in the shade First Fawn. Wonderful contour stick, very smooth, easy to blend, and the product itself is very much pigmented. You just need a tad bit of product. You can work out with this product in your own sweet time. You really don't have to rush and blend the product. So whatever, wherever you want to put your product, put it and then start blending slowly. So one of my favorite products, again by Sugar, and I absolutely love using. So the orange corrector I blended, and then straight up I went ahead with the contour blending. As you can see that my skin doesn't have too much dark circles or heavy pigmentation.
So orange corrector is for the people who have a lot of dark circles or pigmentation around their mouth area. It really cancels out all that. The orange corrector is definitely canceling out my facial area, facial hair, because I don't do my upper lips. So yes, it does cancel a bit, but not a product for my skin tone, or the I don't have those issues. So yes, I should keep myself away from this. But all in all, the orange corrector and the contour stick are wonderful, and you should definitely invest your money on these products. So as I said, I will be going in with the last layer of foundation. So I just went in with my stick foundation on the places where I did my contour and my correction, because I don't like too harsh contour happening on my face. So I like to cover it up with a little bit more foundation. So yes, this is how it is. And you can see the foundation actually covered everything and nothing budged. So the product is buttery, you blend it, it settles down, and then you can work it out further with your foundation on top of these cream products. So Sugar has made really amazing products, and I absolutely love their stick products. In particular, if you ask me, the face forward sticks, the contour stick, the blush stick, the foundation stick, all are well made, made to the perfection. Moving on to setting up the face, so I went ahead with this pressed powder. It has a 15 SPF. I'm not a big fan of this powder. It's a very minimalistic powder. It doesn't show up at all on your skin. I feel it doesn't do any kind of mattifying on my face. I still see a lot of glow happening because of this primer and the serum foundation. But the powder is not something I would say go buy it, because I feel there are much better powders in the market. Moving on to further bronzing contouring, so I went ahead with this palette, which has a blush, a highlighter, and a contour cum bronzer. So I'm just gently doing a little bit of bronzing and contouring simultaneously, just making it more visible. Again, a face palette. If you are a person who doesn't want to buy everything separately, this comes pretty handy, and it is well made. Again, the highlighter is not the outstanding highlighter in the palette. The blush and the contour works absolutely stunning. So if you are looking for a face palette, you can definitely buy this one. It will retail you only for 999, and it is well made for every day. So I went ahead with this face forward blush stick. Again, I said I'm a big fan of face forward sticks and in general this particular whole range. So I went ahead with this cream blush. It's very gentle, the shade is not too deep, and later I went ahead with a powder product on my blush so that it is more visible. And if you mix your cream and your powder product, you will definitely achieve a much better result, or you can just leave it here, you will still look good. You see, the powder blush and the cream blush has worked so wonderfully together that now you can see my blush popping. Moving on to highlighter, I took the highlighter in the palette. Again, I just said it's very subtle, it's not out there. You cannot achieve a very intense highlight with it. But a person who just wants a face palette which does very minimalistic things, you can definitely put in your money here. And then I'm just brushing off a little bit of excess. Moving on to eyes, I personally don't own a single eyeshadow palette by Sugar, just because I felt I have all the shades with me in some of the other palettes, and I really want to restrict myself buying palettes which have same kind of shades and more repetitive shades. But I've heard very good things about the palettes. Maybe later in future, if I really want to buy, I will get soon. But here I just went ahead with this bronzer on top of my lid all over. Just take any brush and just put it all over your lids. It's a very easy peasy look. You really don't have to do too much. And since summers are here, I really wanted to go very minimalistic on my eyes. So I just applied this bronzy shade all over my eyelids. To give a little pop, I did apply this Sugar Metallic Eyeliner. Again, one of the products which you should definitely buy from Sugar or try from Sugar, because they are made to perfection. The pigment, the liner durability, the longevity, the way it sits on the eye, it's amazing. It's 10 on 10. They don't budge, it doesn't smudge, and it doesn't go here and there. It's waterproof and it stays on. Even if you remove it with your micellar water in one go, it will just not come off easily. So yes, metallic eyeliners can go wrong with the formula, but these are amazing. Yes, they are a little on a pricier side, but I got them for flat 50% off. And from the time I've got it, frankly speaking, I do use these liners a lot. So yes, if you're eyeing on metallic eyeliners, you should definitely try the Sugar ones. To give a little more pop to my eyes, I went ahead with this emerald green. You see, I didn't apply any eyeshadow, but these eyeliners itself, you can do a lot, and you can definitely create some nice wing eyeliners. These eyeliners you can actually use as your full eyeshadows also. Just take a little bit on your eyelid and smudge it, and you will achieve really nice shimmery eyes. So all in all, this is like one of my best purchases I have done by Sugar Cosmetic, and I absolutely love using them. I will be getting more shades. So yes, this is a product you should definitely try from Sugar. Moving on to brows, I really don't have to talk too much on this product, because you know I absolutely love this product. It's well pigmented, it's not overly pigmented, so you can work out your brows slowly. The product doesn't settle easily like some products. You just apply, they settle in your hair and they just don't go. They just don't move, and then you have those wonky eyebrows. But this product is well made. It gives you very good pigmentation, but still give you a lot of time to work with your brows. And I absolutely fell in love with this brow pencil. I will definitely be repurchasing this one. So if you're a brow girl and hunting for one, you can definitely try this one. One of the best products by Sugar is their kajals. Again, very inexpensive, waterproof, smudge proof, and it stays for long. Once applied, they don't go anywhere. It's very inexpensive, pocket friendly, and one of my best purchases by Sugar. Moving on to the finishing touches, lipstick is a must. So I went ahead with this Metal Matte Liquid Lipstick in the shade Regal. Again, one of my favorite shades, and I absolutely love using this shade. This is something very different into my lipstick collection, and I absolutely love using this. The formula is very good, high quality. It is non-drying and it stays on. It is not going to just come off after you eat your food. Yes, it does fade away in between, but then you can just go in with a minor touch-up and you are done. So yes, this is the product you should try. At least one shade you will definitely love. To finish the eyes, I went ahead with this Sugar mascara. Again, it's not the best mascara, but for the price, I think you still get lengthening and a decent amount of voluminizing with this mascara. So yes, I would not say go buy this one or try this one. It's not a 100 on 100 mascara, but it is a good mascara for every day. And as you can see, this is like the basic finished look. My face was pretty drying today, so yes, I did felt that my face was flaking. It was not because of any other product, it's my skin. So yes, I absolutely love all the products by Sugar, and I loved my this basic minimalistic look. And I hope you loved watching this one brand tutorial on Sugar Cosmetic. I will be here soon with some more one brand tutorials with some more interesting brands. Do let me know if any other brand you want me to try and do a one brand tutorial. I will be back here with some more new makeup, some more new skincare. Consider subscribing and following me on my Instagram @pranzingi. Till then, you take care and see you soon.